3, 4.
The musical world has its deepest roots in the natural world. Someday, this rough block of wood will give life to Mozart's oboe concerto. This is the Laubin Oboe Factory, and here these craftsmen choose for their renowned instruments the wood of the impingo tree. No other wood has its dark beauty and musical resonance. The impingo gives life to music and to art. In Africa, the Makonde people carve it into sacred sculptures of the ghosts of ancestors who were witches when they were alive.
Nature is made possible by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by viewers like you, your gas company, and America's natural gas industry, who have developed ways to run buses, cars, and trucks on clean natural gas in order to reduce pollution and help preserve the environment. Siemens, a whole new world of ideas in electronics and electrical engineering. Siemens, precision thinking. And by Canon, quality and innovation for the way we work and live. Canon. It's the gift of nature that links music, a carver, a sawmill, a splintering clarinet, and the wildlife of East Africa. It's the wood of the impingo tree, the tree that makes music. At first glance, the impingo is like most of the other trees of the African savanna, an unassuming, thorny, gnarled, yellowish tree. But it contains a great treasure, one which becomes both art and music. It grows in a type of woodland that once stretched all the way from South Africa to Ethiopia in the continent's northeast corner. Now, the impingo survives only in Tanzania and northern Mozambique. The impingo tree, like many trees, is an important barrier against spreading deserts. In addition, it's a valuable factor in the fertility of this land because specialized bacteria living on the roots enrich the soil. And at the end of each dry season, its burst of new growth provides much-needed food for the plains animals. It may not look very impressive, but in its center is a remarkable wood. The impingo tree has been traded along the East African coast ever since the ancient Egyptians crafted its wood into ceremonial staffs, furniture, and ornaments. The Makande people, who live in the southern region of Tanzania, have also had a long traditional bond with the impingo, the national tree of their country. This man and his sons are traveling deep into the bush on a search for the best tree in the neighborhood. The ideal impingo tree should be straight and flawless. It must be at least 60 years old, big enough to justify the labor of cutting it down, but not too big to carry home. Experience and skill are needed to make sure the tree will land on a cushion of branches to prevent splintering and cracking. The impingo is prized for its jet black heartwood. It's also been called African Blackwood and sometimes ebony. The wood is almost as hard and heavy as iron. Anything made from it is immensely strong. It's so tough that the axe needs sharpening every few minutes. It's thirsty work. The land is hot and dry. But those who know where to find a drink by cutting a vine that's full of water. After 2 hours of hard labor, the tree is still holding on by a thread. The Makande are expert carvers. The heartwood of the impingo is very important in their lives. But the impingo plays an important part in Western culture too. From it come some of the liveliest sounds in the musical world.
1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. When you look at a jazz band, or for that matter an orchestra, what you're looking at is a tiny ebony forest, because the fingerboards and the chin rests of string instruments and the black notes on a keyboard of a piano, and of course especially the bodies of woodwind instruments, oboes and clarinets, are all made in the top instruments from Mpingo wood. What you're hearing is nature's voice, a direct connection between nature and music. The connection couldn't be more direct. Here's a marvelous material, this wonderful black wood, which has proved to be the ideal material for making these, to making woodwind instruments, particularly clarinets. And it's for that reason, for those unique tonal qualities and sheer glamour of this material, that makers have been, since the 19th century, making instruments from this wood on an industrial scale.
Among the sawmills scattered along the southern coast of Tanzania, there are a few that specialize in processing Mpingo logs. Foresters in the bush provide this mill with about 600 trees every month. Since the Mpingo is used to make the finest musical instruments, only the highest quality wood passes inspection for export. The wood takes as heavy a toll on the teeth of the saw as on the carver's axe. The Mpingo wood is twisted and full of flaws, and extracting high-quality timber is extremely difficult. The graders reject most of the pieces. At least 90% of the tree ends up on the scrap pile.
Look
Once sealed and bagged, this wood is like gold bullion, the most expensive timber in the world. In the poor, parched country of southern Tanzania, water is a vital commodity. But the Mpingo is almost as crucial. Carved by Makande sculptors, it provides essential income to many of the families here. The extra revenue has allowed this family to build a small village for themselves and has made them relatively wealthy. A single tree may last 6 months. Very little of the precious wood is wasted. The small cuts will be made into souvenirs or chess pieces, while the larger pieces are worked into elaborate sculptures.